Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's video, we will be taking a look at some Android-specific productivity applications. You're probably a bit shocked because I actually own an Android phone. We will be checking them out today, and I wanted to round up a few of the best smaller applications out there that I've recently discovered on the Google Play Store. So guys, before we dive in, a little word from our sponsor. Our sponsor for February 2020 is Zoho Suite. Now, Zoho Suite is a range of products covering sales to help desks to email and much more. They wanted us to focus in on one of their products, which is Zoho Projects. Now, Zoho Projects is a way for your team to manage projects and work in and out of the office. They have features like task management, time tracking, charts, reports, including Gantt chart abilities, plenty of issue tracking features for bugs, and also Zoho Analytics integrations too. With success stories from construction industries to software development, it's a popular place to bring all of your projects into one place. So thanks to Zoho Suite for sponsoring this month on Keep Productive. So the first on our list is an application called Grow Habit Tracking. And there are so many Android habit trackers out there, including the likes of Habitify and Loop. But Grow Habit Tracking is a very simplified version of these tools. Now, most major tools allow advanced tracking and progress mapping, whereas Grow doesn't do that. It allows you to set a habit with, for example, a lot of different, you know, attributes. If you wanted to add, say, a specific day to start, also how long you want the habit to progress on for, and also setting a reminder. And the great thing is, once you've set all of that, for example, meditate every day, you can see your progress by tapping into the card on the page. But it's very subtle. You can see your mini tree grow, and I quite like the details that you can see behind the card. It's not too much, but holds enough information for you to keep progressing with your habit. This application holds a 4.0 on the App Store, and it is free at the moment, which is a good opportunity. So for those who are looking for a very simple habit tracker, this is quite a nice and visually appealing way to start tracking your habits. So the next application up is an application called Focus Productivity Timer. And there's plenty of Android timers out there. And this one, again, is a very super basic one, but allows you to create timers for specific activities using the Pomodoro method. You can also track tasks and sync them with your timers inside of mini cards. And what I quite like about this is it has the ability to add music over the top. Some music you do have to pay for. However, the majority of the basic white noise and wilderness sort of noises in the background work very well and are free to use. This one's free, and I'd recommend it for people looking for a very basic timer experience. Next up is an application that I was pretty impressed with. This is the Postit Notes application for Android. And although being a fairly big company that 3M is, it actually provides a pretty neat, simple experience where you can take these digital notes, for example, anything that you write on Post-it notes, and be able to upload them. But the cool thing is you can actually organize them into like collaborative boards so that you can actually, you know, coordinate a specific group of information. For example, you could have a shopping list and different errands you do on your day, or you could use it for brainstorming and other such activities. But I was pretty impressed by the way that they laid out this application and how easy it is to use. And if you already used Post-it notes, what's cool is you can actually scan them in magically and they get brought into the application. But being able to add the Post-it note in a digital format reminded me a lot of Google Keep, but had a little bit of a sort of edge to Google Keep in allowing you to make these boards and collaborate and organize them in a more fine-tuned fashion. And this is a free app, and I'll include it below. So the fourth application on our list was Your Hour. And as you can imagine, phone addiction is a big problem these days. Many people suffer from it. And I like the iOS application where you can actually see the screen time summary, and you can have that on Mac now. While some Android phones do this, if they're running the latest version of Google, some don't. And Your Hour is a good way to do that. So basically you give it access to the applications that you are running on your phone, and it basically tracks like a timeline of your day, but it also sets you limits. For example, a set 3-hour limit, and it will give you sort of a rundown on how you're using that time. You can also set challenges, which is quite cool. So if you want to take yourself off 1 hour of the phone, it won't let you use that phone. Only let you use a dial abilities, which is pretty cool. So that's one of the many benefits of using this application. The goal behind it is to help you reduce your phone use. But do remember, when you're signing up and naturally getting started with it, it is taking access to some of the other applications that you're using. So just remember that in terms of a privacy aspect. They have over 1 million downloads, but it's worth checking out their privacy details. So just make sure of that. And finally, our final recommendation for Android is Standard Notes. Now, many of you may know Standard Notes if you follow this channel. It's a minimal note-taking application with powerful open source abilities. It's got a real focus on privacy, and it allows you to take notes with custom themes and developer-like settings to really enhance your notes. Now, if you're using it on the free plan, it is really a basic editing or note-taking experience. It's sort of like Simple Notes in terms of like just getting started, but if you are a premium user, it gives you access to the other applications. They've got a range of iOS, Android, Mac and Windows applications, and also they have a Linux one if you need it too. But it's a great note-taking experience and works really well across all devices, but they have loads of different themes inside of premium. So I'll include Standard Notes below, but I think you'll really enjoy that one too. So folks, that was a roundup of Android applications. I am looking to do more Android reviews in the future, so do stay tuned, and I definitely will improve the quality of the videos as well. So a big thank you for stopping by. If you enjoyed some of the recommendations, you can check them out below. Leave a like if you thoroughly enjoyed this video, and subscribe if you're brand new. But we do tons of productivity software features on this channel, so I'm sure you'll find value from that. But guys, a big thank you, and I will talk to you all very soon. And I can finally enjoy this cup of tea.